In today's video, I have Esteban Carrero Bronze. This is a nice premium stick. I got it for $4 and a 5 for 20 pack from this very shop right here. So, those have a nice Barnyardy chocolate, crisp chocolate and Barnyard sweetness, caramel apple maybe. Yeah, caramel apple, hay and sweetness, and Barnyard. And on the foot, it's very sweet too. Like a hay-like substance, not exactly a German chocolate, but like a nice grainy, smooth. All right, so I'm gonna cut it up. Very loose, comfortable, nice draw, box pressed. Yeah, this is a box press, by the way. Packed firmly, a little spongy, but in a firm way, like it feels soft and smooth, but it's packed pretty good too. You can tell it's all packed in there nicely. Kind of like those little Villager smokes, only this is a bigger version. It's packed in a similar fashion to those Villager sticks. Caramel apple sweetness with a little mustiness on the pre-light draw. Let's get going. I'm pairing it with Cost Striker beer today. Light and very good so far. Ooh. Very nice sweetness right off the bat. Pieces in my mouth, but there's a good chance this is very aged also, because it was in a discount sample. But this, you can tell, is easily a $10 plus stick. Fucking hate that. I sit here, I hear people slamming it, they don't shut the door quietly. But anyway, that's very nice draw though, smooth and beautiful. Slight bitterness, but overall that nice sweetness coming in. Retrohale black pepper spice with some. The caramel bite is on here too. The caramel apple taste is in here, I would say. With a heavy black pepper finish. Again, fucking bullshit, swear to God. Anyway, I'll be back in a bit. I'll update the rest of this as it goes. I am back about 15 minutes in, and it's a milk chocolatey caramel apple taste. Yep, the caramel apple is in the light draw. If you just smoke it light and take the time to taste it. On the hard draw, it's more chocolate, milk chocolate and caramel apple. Maybe a bit of a roasted bite also onto that. So, but it's creamy. It's creamy with a little bit of bitterness. A little bit of bitterness. And creamy too. It's a very good smoke so far. A retro ale. A cayenne pepper, black pepper combination. I'll go with. With the caramel apple flavors. Some of the milk chocolate. Like the Godiva variety, probably. With one of those nice caramel apples. That's the flavor, I would say. I'll be back in a little bit. Update a little bit more. Burning even. Good solid smoke output. Very nice on that department of it. So. Okay. About 25 minutes in now. It's about time to remove that first band that says bronze on it. So I am going to do that. Looks like this is a very flaky ash. Probably about to drop at any minute. So. This one's going medium burn, maybe. It's not slowly burning, but it isn't very fastly burning either. I think when it gets to the end, it's going to burn slower, is what I think. The second half. Very good. Taste is decent. A heavy cayenne pepper taste now. On top of the toasted caramel apple. It's now toasted caramel apple. A little bit of I don't know what now. A little bit of nutmeg coming in. A nutmeg with the cayenne pepper. That's the piece that the wrapper took right there. I like this one. Not as much as the Chupacabra, I wouldn't say, though. Well, the Coventry. Or a few others that I've had. But it's decent. It's just not like those. And this has some extra age on it, too. Not the greatest cigar I've smoked, but there are flavors in here. I gotta see how it simmers out, though, as it goes. A little bitter right now, though. So I'll be back. Approaching 40 minutes. Time to remove this band now. First soft ones. Anyway, took a little bit of the wrapper again here. I can kind of see why this one ended up in the discount bin. I mean, a lot of them are good, don't get me wrong, but Someone probably had it. They thought it wasn't worth the money, I'm guessing. But it's burning pretty quick. It's up to 40 minutes right now, actually. Plus, it surprises me for the final half, right? It's about the final half or a little under. So, but the flavor's more bitter. It's a little more uneasy and unsettling now. This, I never would say this about many high-end cigars, but this is one you should put a little infusing into it, like line it with a little alcohol or something to alter the flavor, because it's bitter. It doesn't taste that great. There's some good flavors, but then a bitterness ends up coating it. Maybe even bittersweet. But there's some cedar wood out the retrohale now, with a little of that caramel apple taste, but the retrohale tastes pretty good. It's got a black pepper spice predominantly right now. The cayenne pepper's disappeared for the most part. I'd say it's still good, but just more bitter at times than some. Yeah, the flavors are getting a little bit better now again. But it's a very off and on cigar. There's good flavors, then there's good flavors with bitterness and all that. So yeah, I'll leave it at that for now.